From North Andover, Massachusetts, the Merrimack Sports Network presents Warrior Hockey. Tonight, Hockey East action as Merrimack will entertain the Minutemen of the University of Massachusetts. Bates wins the draw, but Sherry quickly pressuring. Wraparound attempt by Haywood, save, Masterless rebound, score! Jordan Haywood, who turned 24 on Wednesday, gets a birthday present, making it 1-0 Warriors.
Well, seems like it was just a matter of time.
Another win back to Mansfield. Gould had it go off his skate, rebound in front, score! Gustafson on the rebound, and Merrimack has a 2-0 lead. 1 by the Minutemen, back to the point, rebound, and LaRue hit the post, and then it's poked in, the Minutemen are on the board. LaRue on a wide open end hit the post, but it was rebounded home, and UMass is within one. The Walsh power play goal at 15:59. Of this third period. Here's Merrimack with a chance to get a 2-on-1 here. Christie and Collins. Collins, score! Off the post and in! Warriors back up by 2! On the Hospitality Mutual Insurance Company penalty kill. Masterler's still in the net, but now he's coming out. Here's a score! In front, Connor Sheary, and all of a sudden a flurry of goals. It's back to a 1-goal lead. Graysell against Bates. Graysell wins another one. Sent in front, pad save, rebound, score! In front, Carzo on the rebound, and we're tied with 40 seconds to play. Ba will get it. And UMass is going to battle back from 2 goals down in the last 5 minutes and force overtime here at Lawler Arena. A 3-goal third for UMass. Toot, a team that is 1-15-1 when trailing after 2 periods. They have forced an extra 5 minutes here in North Andover tonight. Merrimack is 1-2-6 in overtime. UMass is 1-2-3 in the extra session. Ellis makes a nice move. Shot, rebound, score! Rebound in front of the Warriors have won it in overtime, 4-3. Let's go downstairs and check in with the hero for the second time this year. Connor Toomey wins a game in overtime for the Warriors. The sophomore comes up with the game winner, and Connor, describe the play from the faceoff to you, finding the back of the net.
The faceoff, scored it back to Ellis at the point, and He did a good job getting a shot to the net, and we focused all game on getting bodies to the net, getting shots to the net, so I was lucky to get the rebound and put it in.
Connor, I thought you did a great job of just getting position on the defenseman. You worked your way to the offensive side of him, and you kept your stick on the floor. That's something you work on in practice, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely. Just got the pie in the paint. Yeah, what was the question?
Well, you work to get on the offensive side of the defenseman.
Yeah,
a real good job.
Yeah, definitely. That's what we work. We work on that in practice, just getting on the right side and getting good body position in front and just getting bodies to the net. So.
You wear the pie really well, too.
Thank you.
So, Connor, when you look at UMass coming up with 3 goals in the last 5 minutes of regulation to tie the game, when you get to the bench at the end of the third period, what's kind of the mindset and what's the message from Coach Dennehy to you guys?
The start of overtime, the message was just go take it. Go take it from them. This is our game, our building, so that's what we did, so it feels good.
Do you always ice the puck when in those situations? I mean, I thought that there were a couple of icings tonight that you would have liked to have back so you wouldn't have to take defensive zone faceoffs.
I guess a couple. I think just for the empty net, I think Collins was just trying to get that extra goal. We got tied bodies on there, so he was just trying to get it out.
Sure.
Why not go for the goal?
It's easy for me to say this when the puck isn't icing, as opposed if you sank that, game over.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, Connor, you have 1 regular season game left. You're still alive for home ice. You have to win it, and you need help. BU and UNH have to lose. How important is tomorrow night for you guys? Just go out there and take care of business no matter where you play next weekend.
It's very important. We just got to, the past couple games we have been playing our best. We just got to get back on a roll and just get a full 60 minutes from the team. So a big win going into playoffs would be huge.
All right, Connor, again, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on the game winner and good luck tomorrow night and next weekend.
Thank you very much.
And a reminder to stay tuned to MerrimackAthletics.com following tomorrow's regular season finale for complete details on the 2013 Hockey East playoffs. If Merrimack is on the road next weekend, there'll be fan buses once again. Full details to be announced later this week. And again, check out MerrimackAthletics.com. For our producer and director, KJ Cardinal, and our entire PAC Network crew, and my partner, Don Tutcahoon, Steve Degler saying thanks very much for watching, and so long from Lawler Arena, North Andover, Massachusetts. The final score once again in overtime, Merrimack 4, UMass 3. You've been watching the Merrimack Sports Network.